abysmal. But the firemen has put up a video of adults reacting to me, and I'm kind of nervous to see it, so I'm going to react to it. Normally, I don't do reaction videos to anything, but this is kind of a special deal. This is kind of like a very unique thing. And I don't know how they're going to react to me. I'm kind of nervous because I'm afraid that they're going to hate me. Because anybody who sees me just randomly, I kind of come off very obnoxious and very loud and very panicky. So I have a feeling they might not like me. But it's going to be fun. I'm curious to see what they're going to say. I kind of wish it was teens react to me. I think they might understand a bit more, but we'll see what happens. Oh, God. Okay, here we go. Oh, there's a new intro to it. YouTube stars.
Something.
Can I flip out over there? Yeah, that's fair enough. Yes! Thank you, thank you!
Hey.
I don't think anyone likes me.
Finally!
This guy's commentary definitely makes it way better.
Thank you! Oh god! Just for life! Just for life! You can do this! You can do this!
Oh my gosh.
I did it!
Oh, that's insane. Who is this guy? I need to subscribe to him immediately.
Yes, I do!
Who watches this show? I love that.
I'm really hyped. No, I know what you're thinking. Jack, this is just another one of those stupid games. And yes, you'd be right. Sometimes the stupid games are the best games.
They are the best games.
Yes, I agree. The best game is to shoot people right from the rooftop.
Oh my god, that's disgusting.
Yeah, it is. Don't switch a game, man.
See you, boys.
Yeah.
This is actually a real game.
Oh my god. Yeah, it is a real game.
You might be my son. My son's 14.
Thank you.
Oh, my poo bounces everywhere now.
Oh my god, it's brown everywhere.
Yes.
That's incredible.
Kill everybody.
This guy should make videos. Keep going at it.
Literally. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this, punch that like button in your face. Like a boss.
I like the
bar.
Like myself.
Yes, get into it.
Voice, or his like vocal cords must be really exhausted.
Nah, never.
These are games? Are you kidding me?
I don't know what he's on, but I want to buy it.
It's life, bro.
Twitter comments with Jacksepticeye.
Oh, are you a boy or a girl?
Checking.
Not sure. I think I'm a boy. Would you trade jobs from YouTube for something else? Nope. Not now, not ever. I'm my own boss. I get to meet all these wonderful people.
Fuck you!
I can't think of a job better than this. I get to play video games.
Sweet, great. Winning, winning.
You're a cool dude. So much boss energy. Can I get it like a boss? Okay, but you're all gonna have to join in with me. Okay,
three, do it.
2, 1.
Like a boss!
3, 2, 1.
Like a boss!
Yeah. 1.
Like a boss!
She did not join in. Did you do it? Thank you for dedicating your life to us. It is incredibly touching that you give so much of yourself to make us happy.
I'm so nervous, man.
You guys give me just as much as I give you.
I actually like that when YouTubers, like, you know, actually reach out to people.
You really help me out every day. I'd be so lonely and lost without all of you, so thank you.
That's so cool about YouTube is, like, while you help other people, you also help the person creating.
Thank you guys. This guy watching this video. If you liked it, punch that like button in the face. Oh my god.
So much energy. This guy's related to me. I mean, this is like every time my family comes to my island, they're just like this.
Yes, we are. Oh god, please like this.
What did you think of this YouTube creator who calls himself Jacksepticeye?
He's special. I didn't get what he was saying. I didn't get what's the purpose of it.
He's funny.
He's doing what he does, and he's doing it well. I didn't get to. Oh my god, he's amazing. Like a boss.
Like a boss. Maybe the most popular genre of content on YouTube, which is video game commentary.
Wow. Yep, I don't watch them often, but my little brother does. He's 17. My son is a big gamer. He does Minecraft, and I know he does follow a lot of YouTubers.
Personally, I like it a lot because there's a lot of times where I see a game that I want to play, but I'm just like, do I really want to shell like $60 for it?
Yeah.
So then you can just watch people play and you like see their reactions. So he's one of the fastest rising channels right now on YouTube.
What?
As of this episode, he has nearly 8 million subscribers.
Are you serious?
What the? What did I do wrong in my life? Like I could have been filming myself.
I don't get
these video games, but instead I went to school. I got good grades.
Hey!
And
so did I,
right? So. Props to that guy. And he posts 2 videos every single day. And those videos are anywhere from 13 minutes to well over 20 minutes.
Holy moly, that's a lot.
If he enjoys what he's doing, I mean, all the power to him. That's a lot of work. Like, does he eat? Does he sleep? He must be
running
on, like, 5-hour energies or Adderalls or something. You know, there's some of my favorite YouTubers that put out a video, like, once a week, getting new stuff, like, every day. It's just awesome, man.
Personally, me, I won't be watching him, but...
It's fair enough.
So not just game channels, but also some vlog channels and some of the big Vine stars seem to have these energetic, big, loud, in-your-face personalities, and it's finding success. Why does that personality resonate with so many people? I think maybe just because it's funny.
Sometimes I wonder if they think they have to be loud.
No.
Or, like, have people listen.
Gets people's attention. It's outside of the norm. I think more people should be like this, and then the world would probably be a better place.
Yes!
Like, people aren't that upbeat about their everyday lives, so whenever you watch somebody doing that, you almost get the same emotions, like, vicariously through them.
For years
exactly.
Now,
gaming content like Jax and others have become more popular, yet people don't consider it to be real entertainment. Do you think one day it will shed that stigma?
I think it will be embraced.
As my generation starts getting older, that stigma's gonna be gone forever. These younger generations were just, like, the first people playing video games like me. Now, let's say when I'm 30, 40 years old and my kid's watching a guy play a game, to me it's a good, yeah, totally. Like, I was doing the same thing, like Dota or something. It's, like, on ESPN now. Like, I saw it,
yes.
So now that ESPN, like, a sports thing, is starting to do, like, video games, so it's, I think it's moving its way up.
I think it's coming in more accepted. Things are changing, and it's changing to the worst, in my opinion. And this is something that we have to look into and we have to work around, rather than say, okay, we're gonna stop it, because it's not gonna stop.
So back to Jacksepticeye. His videos reach a wide demographic, from adults and teens, but also with younger kids. What are your thoughts about that?
I just feel like it's universal.
I think it's testament to Mr. Jacksepticeye that he spans, you know, these different generations.
Right, like, because he is that, like, I don't call him like a cartoon personality, but that loud personality. And then teens like him because he's funny. The adults that like him, maybe they're gamers. He hits their, like, funny bone. That they just hit the comedy that they like.
Jacksepticeye
made a huge effort to connect with his fans through social media and his videos, which is something new in the entertainment industry. Do you think that's an important thing to connect with fans in this way?
I think it's important because he values it. He's telling you that he cares.
It's cool to have that dynamic of knowing somebody on YouTube when you haven't even met them.
It's becoming more interactive, right? Versus TV, it's just somebody's, you know, throwing stuff at them and they can't say anything.
It goes deeper than I'm not just a viewer and now I feel like I'm part of the actual creation of what I'm watching. As well as I'm connecting with the people on the screen at a deeper level. I sent a message to another YouTuber. He actually responded. I was like, oh, like, it actually like kind of made my day that he responded, you know, and it made me want to watch him more.
Exactly. Last question, Jacksepticeye will likely watch this episode of the show. So we are asking everyone to give your best Jacksepticeye impression.
Oh my god. Good morning, Tia, that is. My name is Jacksepticeye.
If you like that video, give it like a punch in the face and like a boss.
Like a boss.
YouTuber kind of thing, you kind of look at it and go, good god, I do not like that. That's loud. That's in my face all the time. Which I've embraced. That's what I like to do. I that's who I am. I love doing it. And obviously a lot of you people like it as well. So like, I don't mind if other people don't like it. That's the right to do. But that was fun. It was awesome. All your impressions, by the way, top notch. Some of them really, really understood what YouTube was about. Some of them really understood like the whole interactivity, why some people watch the channel, why they might feel like, because like I said, while it is very abrasive content, it is very obnoxious and in your face and very loud all the time, it goes much more beyond that. Like, there's the connection there. You feel like you're playing the game along with me. You feel like you're there in the same room that I'm addressing you and talking right to you. And then the connection between like doing reading comment videos, talking directly to the camera, doing the vlogs and those kind of things, those help connect as well. So it's much more than me just sitting down and pumping out entertainment for you. That's what I like to do. I do provide entertainment. Shut up, phone. I do provide entertainment for a lot of people, but it's a whole lot more than that. And I'm really glad some of them seem to understand that. Some of them got that straight away, that it was more than just like, oh, I'm sitting down and watching somebody make jokes. And hopefully some of that came across in the videos they chose. I didn't get to read some of the messages at the bottom of the screen that they went through. So, I don't know, hopefully those are good as well. But I like that! That was fun! Ah, yay! I leave a link in the description so you can go watch the original as well, so I'm not talking over it if you haven't seen it already. I probably should have said that at the start, to go watch the other one first, because I probably would have talked over parts that you wanted to hear in the video, so I'm sorry about that. I'm so flattered, more than anything, to be part of that. Like, to have people not only request a video to be made about me, which is super flattering, but to be on, like, the Fine Brothers channel to be reacted to, because they have their YouTubers react, and to be on that is, like, a really big honor, and to be flattered to be asked to be in that, to react to other stuff, but to have people actually react to you as a YouTuber, that's just mind-blowing. That's incredibly humbling, and I don't know, it gives me a lot of drive and motivation and energy to go off and do more. I said that in my vlog already recently, but I wanted to, like, I don't know, it makes me feel good about what I'm doing. It makes me feel like what I'm doing is actually something good and something right and something proper. And I don't know, thank you for, like, making a video about me. And thank you, any of you who requested it. And thank you all for watching this video. I'm just incredibly happy right now. I'm incredibly flattered and humbled and happy. And, I don't know, I can't wait for you guys to see this. And a lot of you have probably seen the original video already. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, punch that like button in the face. Like a boss. And, bye guys, all around. Thank you guys, that was while other people were doing it on screen and trying to do an impression.